shop stores that host TikTok, it would levy a $10,000 a day fine for hosting TikTok. That's $2.5 million a year for TikTok. TikTok has 150 million users. That's a lot of people using TikTok. Obviously, we've seen this discussion over the last couple of years about banning TikTok federally, about potentially forcing a sale. Well, this TikTok bill in Montana goes much further than any other bills, which, as you mentioned, focus on state devices, right, Western?
Thank you. report that one of the four SUVs from Prince Harry's security escort was driving in a manner that could be perceived as reckless. The vehicle was seen blocking off streets, and in one video, it is shown being pulled over by the police. Not surprising, of course, that there are differing accounts here, right? So we're also hearing from the taxi driver who picked up the couple. He said that Harry and Meghan were nervous and scared in his car.
It was their security guard, he said, where they were going, right? And as soon as he's about to say where they're going, all of a sudden, the paparazzi just stormed the taxi. And there's flashes coming from every direction. They up against the car, just taking pictures and stuff like that, standing in front, you know. And then as we got stuck behind the garbage truck, when the garbage truck moved, they started following the cars in there behind us.
The NYPD called the incident challenging, did not characterize it as a chase, and noted that there were no reported collisions, injuries, or arrests. Boris?
Here's a look at some of the other headlines we're following this afternoon. The South Carolina House has passed a controversial bill that would ban most abortions as early as 6 weeks. Democrats filed more than 1,000 amendments to try and deter Republicans from passing it. The bill now heads back to the GOP-controlled state Senate. Meantime, convicted biotech fraudster Elizabeth Holmes has been ordered to report to prison by May 30th. Yesterday, the Theranos founder requested a pause on her 11-year sentence while appealing her conviction. The judge, though, denied her request. And the suspect gave authorities the slip for nearly 20 years. But now a man has finally been indicted for stealing a pair of the original ruby slippers that Judy Garland wore in The Wizard of Oz. Authorities claim he broke into the Judy Garland Museum in Minnesota in 2005, smashed a glass case, and stole the iconic footwear. Jim?
Well, after multiple delays, the man charged in the stabbing death of Cash App founder Bob Lee was arraigned today in a San Francisco court and will remain behind bars. Nima Momeni pleaded not guilty to plunging a kitchen knife